28th of January 2014, Matthew Sinclair, who I know personally, and is a good friend of my older sister Jasmine, had a terrible car accident. This accident was not alcohol related or an act of recklessness. It was dusk when the sun was low, when Matt was driving his friend home from basketball training. They were driving on dirt road just out of Stansfield on the York Peninsula and began to embed. The sun hit them both in the eye and neither of them could see a thing. Not knowing the road was straightened, Matt continued to turn the bend, which caused the youth to roll about 50 metres into a nearby cutting. The passenger in the car with him, Alicia Redden, sister of Port Adelaide player Jarrad, came out with only a few cuts and bruises, but Matt's condition was much worse. As the car rolled, it first landed on Matt's side, which dented the roof over Matt's head. Matt suffered a traumatic brain injury, a double fractured arm, and was unresponsive at the time. I was working at the local hotel in Kibawi when the policeman got the call in regards to the accident. One of the owners of the hotel came up back to inform us of what happened. When I heard Matt was in the car, my heart stopped. I called my sister, but at that point, the only information I had was that he was going to the Royal Adelaide Hospital in a critical condition. Just a couple of days after the accident, Jasmine was by his side at the hospital. She was worried that if she left for her overseas trip, that he could wake up and would not remember her. She visited him a number of days before leaving. One of the days she was visiting, Matt was strong enough to lift both arms, even though he was in such pain. This, I'm sure, gave his friends and family hope that he could pull through this. Matt was placed in an induced coma with the top of his skull removed, so the brain would not press against the skull as it was swelling from the accident. While Matt was at the RAH, he underwent 5 operations, 1 CT scan, 4 MRI scans, and numerous chest x-rays. He was in the induced coma for about 4 months before he was then transferred to the Hampstead Rehabilitation Centre, physio and speech therapy. Now that Matt is at the Hampstead Rehabilitation Centre, he's been responding much more. He still can't talk, but he's communicating by blinking. He has been using a machine that will help that helps his leg, work his leg muscles, which will help when the time comes for him to learn to walk again. Just a couple of weeks ago, Matt smiled for the first time in 7 months, which is a significant improvement for himself and a pleasant surprise for Jenny, his mom. Matt was one of those guys who had a hobby personality, and he was someone who was full of life. He loves sports including surfing, motorbike riding, fishing, and football. Many of the activities he loved doing, he would never be able to do again due to the accident. These kinds of accidents happen all the time. Most commonly they are alcohol related or due to recklessness, but in some cases they could be a simple misjudgment, which in Matt's case it was. Whenever you see someone in the news that has had an accident, it doesn't seem to affect you. But when it's someone you know, whether it's a family member or a friend, it hits you pretty hard. You never know when this can happen to someone close to you, but it can happen to you. I can only imagine the heartache Matt